We long to see thee so, to see thee newly born. We long for Christmas morn. The sands of time run slow. Oh come, oh come, oh come, our Savior dear to be. Oh come, oh come.
Good day, viewers. I invite you to reflect with me on the theme, Seeking for Discernment. Saint Joseph was a man that we know little about, but think about the importance of his role in salvation history. He was entrusted with the Son of God as his little child. At first, he was confused about how Mary could have gotten pregnant. But upon receiving the words of the angel in a dream, he accepted this child as his own and cared for him with a father's love. It is significant to note that Saint Joseph embraced the Christ child because of a dream. But was it only a dream? We all have many dreams, and some of them are strange and nonsensical. So why did Saint Joseph rely upon the authenticity of this dream? The answer to this question is quite simple. Even though the dream he had was just that, a dream, it was also accompanied by the gift of faith. Joseph knew with a certainty beyond human reason that the voice of God had spoken to him, and he responded with generous faith. We may not have dreams through which God speaks to us in the form of an angel, but God does speak to us all day long. He speaks directly to our minds and hearts, and also through the care and mediation of countless hosts of angels in various ways. The angels of God are constantly bringing us divine messages and inspirations. The question is whether or not we are listening. Listening to the voice of God through the mediation of the angels is not about us seeing or hearing the angels speak. Rather, it is a matter of discerning this language of love spoken to us and calling us to faith. Listen in the silence of our heart this day and allow ourselves to follow the glorious witness of Saint Joseph as he responded to our Lord's will with perfect faith and trust. Another way of seeing today's gospel is also relating it with our emotions. Joseph was stunned with the shock of his life. Mary was found to be with child. How do you deal with very challenging situations? Sometimes one gets emotionally upset and takes rash decisions. Joseph gave a model of emotional management, especially of anger and frustration for us. We need patience to deeply comprehend the meaning and message of given situations. St. Paul tells us that where sin abounds, grace abounds even more. This shows clearly in Joseph's contentment of his anger amid his apparent disappointment. In his discerning process, the angel comes to his aid. When emotionally upset, we are encouraged not to rush into action. Patience is our great tool of appropriating God's blessings. Matthew reminds us that Jesus was born of Mary, the betrothed of Joseph, a son of David. The birth of Jesus brings in the here and now, God's presence. The name is Emmanuel, God with us. The popular song says, "Great things happen when God visits with us." How do I create environments that nourish me, refresh me, spiritually and otherwise, and God's abiding presence? Joseph's attitudinal response to pregnant Mary's situation modeled for us patience in a moment of crisis, submissiveness to divine inspiration, active participation in God's plan. May through his intercessions, we await the nativity of our Lord in an attitude of joyful embrace of the word of God. Thank you very much for listening.
O come, O come.